Welcome back. The Modern Army Combatives Program began in 1995, and since then has become the standard for Army close combat training.
Here's Staff Sergeant Mark Decker with one unit competing to train.
Jackson from Service Company and Pagan from Echo 144 to the scores table.
Fort Hood soldiers fought vigorously for top honors, winning pride for themselves and appreciation from their leadership and peers last week. The 69th Brigade, 4th Battalion, 5th Air Defense Artillery hosted a combatives tournament for 83 competitors last Thursday morning. This event drew twice as many soldiers as the last one, largely because of the emphasis this unit has placed upon close combat survivability.
But we do it every 6 months because it's significant and important, not only to the fighters that are fighting today, but those that are watching and observing training can see the significance of doing combatives on a monthly basis. And some units are a little bit more aggressive and they do it on a weekly basis.
Holding tournaments increases morale and camaraderie, but also helps units evaluate how well soldiers will handle close combat with an enemy.
The reason why we stress the combatives on a monthly basis or a weekly basis is because of the dynamic nature of warfare. And where we're going, you may have to use some of these skills.
The combatives training cycle allows certified soldiers to instruct or assist instruction of any untrained soldier. The tournament's heavyweight class runner-up wants to help improve his peers' performance.
I would like to train the soldiers better because combatives is a warrior test. Some units kind of step over and don't really do as much as others. So short-term goals, yes, I would like to bring it more into the unit and make it more of a unit thing.
These tournaments provide a relatively safe and fun way to evaluate battlefield survival skills and inspire interest in combatives training. Reporting from Fort Hood, I'm Army Staff Sergeant Mark Decker, 7th Mobile Public Affairs Detachment.